have a little bit more of those thoughts. So I can use the balance to have a little bit more so that we can actually do it. welcome everyone. I think it would be very nice if we can kind of put the room a little bit closer, maybe remove the seats that are not in use.
Yes.
Yes, feels much better like this. Yeah. Makes more sense. So tonight we would like to share with you some very special music. Actually, the kind of mantras, or in the way that I share the mantras, is different to the traditional kirtan style. It's not in the same way of bhakti yoga. Basically, I use the mantras to create a context that is sacred, that has high vibration, that is pure, so that something else can happen. Whatever that is, has nothing to do with the mantras itself. I'm saying the mantras is not the highest. Whatever the mantras are pointing to, that's what we want to encounter in this evening. So the mantras just create the right context for things to happen, right? Let's say you're having a stomach pain and you go to the doctor and the doctor is looking at you and says, oh, you need a surgery, you need to remove your appendix. So he comes up to you with a knife and he's trying to cut you open. So you naturally pull back and say, no, this is not the right context, right? You cannot have a surgery just like that in an office. You need the right context, you need to be surgery room, schedule that, everything should be clean. So mantras create the right context for something else to happen. And that something else is what is really interesting and extraordinary. And it's something that was not there available maybe 30 years back, but now it is. So I'm traveling around the world, basically spreading this message bringing this energy that changed my life. Once you get something very precious in your life, you cannot stop thinking about it, you cannot stop talking about it. So slowly my life became a message of that, through the music. That's why I call these evenings Awakening Through Music. So each mantra is basically a kind of technology of consciousness that can address the unconscious mind, where everything is happening. Our perceptions of life are connected with how we feel about life. And your feelings are connected with your decisions. Because if you feel you're a big success, it's very different to feel I'm a big failure. You know, the kind of decisions you will take, how you will present yourself, how you will talk to others. So decisions are connected with your actions. And your actions create your life, your destiny. So mantras can plant a seed in your conscious mind where everything happens when you start seeing life. And creates a shift in perception. As consciousness changes, perception changes together with consciousness. And all of our problems are because of low levels of consciousness only. So I would like to share a mantra for wealth consciousness, because our ancestors said that in order to live a complete life, you need to go through four main pillars of life. First pillar is called Artha, in Sanskrit means creating wealth. Only if you create enough wealth, you can move to the second pillar of life. The second pillar is called Kama, or fulfillment of desires. What happens if you have enough wealth? You start fulfilling yourself. Let's say you like to paint, then you can go to Europe, get inspired in the galleries. You can go to your favorite mountain and spend a week painting the mountain. Because you have enough wealth, you can do it. So you start fulfilling yourself. So in the beginning, it's all about you, my desires, my dreams, my family, my house.
after a while, that starts to feel meaningless. People who have it all, they start feeling empty. So you move to the third pillar. Unless you start contributing to life in some kind of meaningful way, life becomes meaningless. As you keep on helping others, it's not because you're a saint or you're a compassionate being. You need it. You need to have a meaning. You need to help others to have a beautiful life. You start moving to the fourth pillar that is connected with mukti, or awakening. That means that's the state of consciousness that all kinds of yoga are trying to achieve. A mindless state, where there are no thoughts. So the journey is a journey of fulfillment. As you fulfill your desires, you move towards a state of meditation. So this mantra is to grow in wealth consciousness. There are different kinds of consciousness. Let's say you want to improve your health. Well, first you need to increase your health consciousness. If you want to create more wealth in your life, you need to increase your wealth consciousness. And wealth consciousness increases whenever you're able to put your attention in the things that you have. The mind is all the time looking for the things that are missing in your life. If you have 10 desires and you could feel 9 of them, you're constantly thinking about that one thing that you didn't get. Why? Because the mind says, it's not enough. I don't have what I want. I need something else. I need something more. I'm not complete. And you will never be complete like that. People who are wealthy feel wealthy because they know what they have. They are aware and they are conscious of what they have. And your wealth is not only how much money you have. If you have health, that's part of your wealth. If you have good relationships, part of your wealth. Your talents, your skills, your education, your goods, everything is part of your wealth only. The moment you start becoming aware, look at my life, I'm so wealthy, you start feeling it. Not as trying to trick yourself that you should have positive thinking in order to attract more of what you want. You are wealthy. You start becoming conscious of your wealth. And that's the first step to create more wealth. So during this chant, just look into your life and see how wealthy you are. When I started seeing my life in this perspective, I realized I'm so wealthy. I'm living my dream, traveling around the world, sharing awakening to music. Everything is happening. I have great relationships. I'm healthy. I have my talent. I have my opportunities. I have my wealth. And everything started changing for me. So let's make use of this energy of Mahalakshmi to increase wealth consciousness. Thank you.